Hello class 8 and welcome back to your online class. Today we will be continuing with children at work. To recapitulate, we left Velu and his newfound friend, the rag picker girl, in front, not exactly in front, but at the backyard of a wedding reception, a place where the wedding ceremony was going on, and they were in the garbage dump just at the back of the hall, trying to find some untouched food. Okay, so the girl found something for him to eat, that is one banana and a vada. Okay, so she found something for him to eat and he reluctantly took it. He reluctantly ate it because he had no other option. Okay, he had to eat something because he was very, very hungry. Now come to page number 13. Let us continue with this chapter. It's too early. They have only eaten tiffin. If you're still hungry, you'll have to wait for them to finish lunch. So this girl is telling him that it's too early. In this kind of wedding reception, she knew, she had an idea about what the meal times were, how they would keep, whenever a big meal would come after the meal was over, the leftovers would be kept in the garbage dump. Okay, she knew all about it. So she was just informing him that if you want more food, we have to wait. It's too early. They have not eaten lunch yet. So you have to wait till lunchtime to see if they give us some more leftovers. Okay. You can wait if you want. I have to work. So she was all business. And this is so amazing coming from a little girl of that age. I'm going. She picked up a couple of bottles from the heap and threw it into her sack. So she had a full-time job. She knew that she couldn't wait there with Velu because she had a job. Then she walked off. Velu panicked. Obviously he would panic. He had no idea where he was. He had no idea. He knew nobody in that big town. He just knew that this girl had given him food, so maybe this girl might help him more. He realized that if the girl left him, he had no idea where he was and what to do. It was better to stick to her. She seemed to know her way around. He ran after her again. So he understood that this girl knew a lot about this place, about this big city, so it was better to be with her. "Hey," he called. He did not even know the girl's name. "Hey, what is your name?" he asked, hurrying behind her. "So what is your name?" She stopped and turned around. "Oh-ho, so you have been following me around without even knowing my name."
"Jaya."
So she said that my name is Jaya.
"I'm not following you."
"What then? Who got you food? So if you have not been following me, who gave you food? You followed me, that's why you got food."
"Can I come with you? Where are you going?"
Velu had no other choice. He had to beg the girl to give him company because he wanted to be with somebody who knew the place. Okay, he had no other option. So he asked her whether he could be with her. Okay, whether he could follow her around.
"Come if you want. This bag is full. I have to go home to get another one."
So this bag which she was carrying was full. She had already picked up a lot of plastic bottles and other wastes which can be recycled, right? Which can be sold off. So she went, she said to him that I'm going back to my home and I have to get another sack. Now come to the third section of the chapter. Jaya and Velu walked along the roads for half an hour until they came to a bridge across a dirty trickle of water. A very familiar scene in a town or a city. That dirty trickle of water reminds you of the big drainage system, which is not properly done. That means the sewage system, no matter how developed the city is, the sewage system, the drainage system is never proper. Okay. So they came to a bridge across a dirty trickle of water. Okay. So it was a drain which was running
and over that there was a bridge. We are in Triplicane now. See, that's Buckingham Canal. That is Buckingham Canal, said Jaya. Velu stared. This was a canal, so he had no idea that a canal can be this dirty and this narrow. Near some puddles of water was a row of the strangest huts he had ever seen. Okay, he was a village boy. He was accustomed to seeing huts and thatched houses, thatched roofed houses, but he had never seen this kind of houses, this kind of huts. They were very strange to look at. They were built out of all sorts of things. Underline this portion. They were built out of all sorts of things. If I ask you the description of the huts, you can write this answer, okay? Metal sheets, tires, bricks, wood and plastic. They stood crookedly and looked as if they would fall any moment. So they were just erected out of whatever material they could get their hands on, which tells us that the people who lived there had no did not have the luxury to afford even a proper housing, even a proper thatched hut, okay, thatched roof hut. They had to make do with whatever they found. They stood crookedly and looked as if they would fall any moment. That means they were not properly constructed at all. Okay, whatever they could find, they would just keep it. Suppose they got two metal sheets, they will keep it here. Keep another metal sheet over there. There would be no binding material except maybe just a plastic sheet which they found for covering it up. So it looked very weird for Velu. He was not accustomed to seeing things like that. They stood crookedly. Crookedly means in a very crooked fashion they were erected. It means not straight at all. And it looked as if they would fall any moment. Is this where you live? These houses are strange, said Velu. In our village, the houses are made of mud and palm leaves. So he informed her that we also live in huts, but in our village, the huts are made of mud and palm leaves. So you see, nature is much more kinder to its poor ones. If you live near the lap of nature in a village which is far away from the development of the society, it is much more easier to be a poor person in a village than being a poor person in a city. Okay, the disparity is a lot. Jaya went around to one of the huts and dumped her sack outside. Then she picked up an empty one. So probably this was the place where Jaya lived. Okay. So she kept her sack and she took up a new one, empty one. Let's go. She turned to Velu and gave him a shove. Shove means push. Okay, like this. Let's go. At least help me now. Here, wear these and come with me. Okay, so she understood that Velu would be accompanying her everywhere. So at the least he could do was work with her, right? So she gave him something. What did she give him? She threw him a pair of old shoes without laces and pushed a sack and stick into his hand. Okay, the stick attached with the sack. If you have seen the rag pickers, okay, it is not uncommon in our town, is it? You may have seen rag pickers and maybe some children also. Anyway, so she gave him this stick. And towards the end of the stick, the sack was there and he had to carry the stick in this fashion, holding the bag of all the different kinds of garbages that they would carry. And then she also gave him a pair of shoes because he did not have any. Velu was confused. What work did she want him to do with these things? The only work he had ever done was on the landowner's farm, weeding and taking cows out to graze. So he was accustomed to those kind of work in the farm. Okay, but he had no idea what this girl would ask him to do. Are there any farms in the city? He asked her. He asked Jaya. So he was a very innocent boy. By now he couldn't understand what the work this girl was doing. Okay, so he was confused. What work am I supposed to do with this sack and this stick? Are there any farms here that we can go and work? She laughed and thumped her stick on the ground. Farms? There are no farmers here. We are rag pickers. Okay, there are no farmers here. You think that we are farmers? There are no farms here and neither are we farmers. Okay. So, we are rag pickers. This is our profession. Rag pickers? Okay. So, this is Velu's first idea about what a rag picker does. He had no idea this profession existed till this moment. See my sack? Full of things I collected. See, in this sack I am keeping all the things which I collected. Collected from where? Collected from where? Asked Velu. From rubbish bins. Where else? That is, I get all these things from the rubbish big garbage dumps. You collect rubbish? Velu had never heard of such a thing. So you collect rubbish? Who collects rubbish? We throw away rubbish. You collect rubbish? Hey, blockhead. Blockhead means a stupid person. Okay. So you are being stupid. It's not any rubbish. Only paper, plastic, glass, such things. We sell it to Jam Bazaar Jaggu. Okay. So we sell these things to a guy. This is how we work. Who's Jam Bazaar Jaggu? Why is he buying all this? Okay. No. Velu was puzzled. He had heard of people throwing away rubbish. But why would anyone want to buy rubbish? So this was beyond him. He could not understand this. Who's Ram Bazaar Jaggu? Why is he buying all this? Why is the person buying rubbish? You think he buys it for show? He sells it to a factory. Come on, I don't have time to waste like you. So she is just bored of giving him one after another description of what the work entails. Okay, but she has a lot of work to do as well. Velu did not move. He hadn't run away and come to this new place to dig through garbage bins. Jaya poked him with her stick. Okay, so she was carrying the stick and she was poking at him. That is, you have to go. Look here, she shouted. If someone gets here before us, we don't get anything. Don't just stand there posing, big hero. I'm trying to help you. Who filled your stomach today? So she can understand the dilemma he is facing. Okay, because she can understand what it must feel like to work as a rag picker for the first time. She's trying to understand, but she's also trying to make him see the sense of all this. She's trying to make him understand that if you don't work with me, if you don't stay with me, you will go hungry. Okay, and I don't have any time for doing that. So if you just stand there posing, then nothing will be accomplished. Velu scratched his head and sighed. I'll do it for now, he thought, until I find a better job. So he still had that dream, that big city dreams with which he came. Wow. That means he wanted to escape a bad life and he wanted to come to a place where he would get a good life. And so he consoled himself and agreed to Jaya's proposal for joining her in the trade when he told himself and he told himself that he would find a better job than this, and till that point of time he would be doing this job. Okay, so let us stop over here. This chapter is completed. We would just go through the chapter one more time and discuss the question answers with you. Okay, thank you.